Whether you're an experienced leader, an aspiring leader, or just obliged to be a leader, there'll be something in this series that will be useful to you. Welcome to this episode of the Leadership Lens Sessions. In this program, we're going to focus on how and why things sometimes go wrong or do not go to plan. To keep with our aim of keeping our programs concise, this program has been split into four separate episodes. Each episode will cover different reasons for why things sometimes go wrong and give some strategies and reflective questions to help you manage them. As always, there'll be an infographic to go with the program, and this will be available in episode 4. During this program, I'm going to refer to failures, mistakes, and errors as FMEs for short. This term also covers the times where things just go off track or are slow to progress and to get started. First thing to think about with FMEs is they will occur. They're just part of life. We can expect them. Sometimes we can avoid or prevent them. Sometimes we just have to deal with them and move forward. A key thought here is that to be able to avoid, react, respond, and deal with them, we first need to be aware of when and why they might happen. Now, just to clarify, don't think of this as you having to go looking for problems and actively seeking them out. Look at it with the focus and mindset and intention of you being aware of the potential causes of problems and some of the signals that show you that problems may be brewing. All big behaviors and issues start small. So, with this in mind, catch things early and the potential impact will be less. The solution will be easier to find and things will get back on track quicker. When dealing with FMEs, I think we only have a few available actions. Number one, stop them happening in the first place. Number two, stop them growing big. Number three, minimize any impact if they do grow. And number four, make a plan to get better at point one. To do all of this, we first need to have the right information and feedback, and also understand what the causes could be and what signs to look out for. Okay, we're back to culture again. Prevention, impact reduction, and reflection are all part of how we do things. And it's okay to get things wrong. It's okay to be reflective. It's okay to regroup, re-aim, refocus. It's okay to problem solve. And we need to have a culture that says actually, we value and encourage these things. To manage FMEs effectively, the culture needs to be strong and provide great communication, safety, teamwork, problem solving, support, growth, and risk taking. It's all about this. This quote is really good. Mistakes are a fact of life. It's the response to error that counts. When dealing with FMEs, the word identify is really important. We need to know where they began. What was the root cause? You can't do anything if you don't know about it in the first place, and you can't do anything effectively if you don't know what the real issue or root cause is or was. Not being able to identify what the root cause to your FME is a real blocker, because all you're ever going to be doing is responding, reacting, and dealing with the symptoms and effects. And without addressing the real issue, there is a very strong risk of things being repeated and reoccurring over and over again. In the following episodes of this program, I'm going to look at 12 common root causes of FMEs. There may be more, but these are the common ones that I think lead to many FMEs occurring. There is a comorbidity in that an FME may have elements of one or more root causes. There is also a crossover where some of the root causes present themselves in similar ways, so you're going to need to do some digging sometimes to find out the primary root cause. So, here is the list of the root causes that I will cover in the following three episodes of this show. In episode 2, we're going to look at the root causes of because they can, because of fear and anxiety, because of competing priorities, and because someone just forgot. In episode 3, we're going to look at the root causes of misunderstanding and misinterpretation, because someone didn't know where or how to start, because there was no follow-up, and because there was no completion date. In the final episode, we're going to look at the root causes of a lack of belief in the importance, value, or intention of the change task or activity, because of ostrich syndrome, because of a lack of confidence and because of a lack of resources. We will be adding new content each week, so don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that alert bell to get notified when we upload a new program. If there is a particular area or issue you'd like us to cover during the series, leave us a comment or send me an email. I look forward to hearing from you.